So do you want to put your vision and mission out there and really make a difference on this planet? If you do, on this next episode of La Dolce Vita, the Formula for Fabulous Living, I'm dedicating this show to an amazing man, Stephen Hawking, and sharing with you my philosophy on creating a vision and mission that's inspiring. So stay tuned.
Frankie Lee, dimmi.
Quale senso della vita?
The meaning of life is to live la dolce vita, which is the formula for fabulous living.
Hi, my name is Heather Picken, and welcome to the La Dolce Vita Show, the formula for fabulous living. I'm the catalyst in helping you to be more confident, create your dream business, and attract elite clients, and live a fabulous life. Here's Heather, helping you to upgrade your life to
fabulous. Upgrade your life to fabulous, right, Frankie? You're fabulous.
Welcome to another episode of La Dolce Vita, the formula for fabulous living. You know, one of the reasons why I do this show is that I am so inspired to change consciousness on this planet. I do that in involving women and women leaders. Maybe you're a woman entrepreneur and you're listening to this, and you want to go to the next level of your business. I'm here to tell you, how you evolve yourself is how you see yourself, how you put your mission and your vision out there in the world, breaking through your biggest fears. That's why I do this show. I could talk about this 24/7. So if we were to have coffee, I would be talking about philosophy, talking about the universal ideas, and sharing with you how to evolve your business. Like, you know, I'd say, come on, girlfriend, you're playing too small, right? You got to play on a bigger scale. Now, I actually want to highlight this show with someone that passed away recently, Stephen Hawking, and he was a world-renowned scientist. He was pretty interesting because he didn't allow his disability, he was in a wheelchair for most of his life, he didn't allow his disability to cloud his vision. And I want to share some quotes. So maybe you're watching this on over on heatherpicken.com. And if you are, here, do me a favor. Could you do me a solid? Could you click on the rate, review, or actually the subscribe button on YouTube? Because that's how more women just like you are going to find this show. If you're on iTunes, please rate and review and subscribe. So give it a 5-star rating. Review it. What did you like about this episode or another episode? This is so important to me because I am a woman on a mission, a woman to inspire other women and other leaders to give themselves permission to do something extraordinary on planet Earth. And what greater way to dedicate this episode right now to Stephen Hawking. So he died on March 14th. He died on Pi Day and Albert Einstein's birthday. So my question is that synchronicity? I think that's pretty fascinating. But I wanted to, I was reading an article. I'm actually have it right. I have it pulled up on my screen. And I found some interesting quotes that he had. And I found that they were very inspiring. You look at the legacy that he left on this planet and how he's literally changed the worldview of how we see the universe and helping other scientists to really, you know, go dig into the mystery of, you know, the questions that we have out there. And so why am I sharing this with you? Well, number one, I feel that he's inspiring. He had a mission and vision of what he wanted to do, and he did it. He didn't let his disability get in the way. I think that's really important. Another thing is that, you know, he is really leaving a legacy. His vision was so vast and so big that he wanted to study and pursue the laws of the universe And really what he did in essence is he created a vision that impacted millions of people on this planet. And that's important for you to know, because if you have a business, if you're listening to this and you're like, you know what, Heather, I really want to make an impact. This is how you do it. You expand your mind, you expand your space and time, and you think larger, you think bigger. It's like you have to be out in outer space, literally. Well, maybe not literally, metaphorically, and looking down on earth and asking yourself, who can I empower today on this planet? So I'm going to read some of these quotes that I thought were interesting and kind of give you my take and how this ties into your business and your life. One of the quotes he has is, life would be tragic if it weren't funny. You know, and I love it. It goes back to, you know, there's out of tragedy, you know, you can always create comedy. Look at the comics or comedians today, and they're kind of making fun of the politics and what is going on in the world. And honestly, it kind of diffuses the situation. I mean, wouldn't you agree? You have to make fun of yourself. I know personally, I like making fun of myself because I'm serious, but at the same time, I am goofy. I'm silly. I'm always trying to find, you know, funny in everything that I can do, kind of turn it around. Another thing that he said, let's see, I'm gonna go to another quote. Oh, this is great. My expectations were reduced to zero when I was 21. Everything since then had been a bonus. So what's interesting about that is when he was diagnosed with ALS, so that just basically deteriorated his body to where he had to be, you know, confined in a wheelchair. And he basically said, hey, everything else is a bonus in my life. And he was able to change his current state of where, you know, he accepted where he was at and create something that was pretty amazing. So, you know, here's the thing. You know, maybe you have something blocking you in your business and life, and you know, you can't get unstuck. And the thing is, first you got to face it. You've got to face whatever's in the way, and you can't beat yourself down for things that have happened to you in the past. And this is what people do. When I work with women all over the world, one of the things that they start doing, they compare themselves to other people, they beat themselves up, I'm too old, you know, insert any excuse that you want to do, but or say, I just think it's important that you get beyond what you perceive your limitations. Because here's the thing, you can always argue for your limitations. You know, when I'm working with clients, I might say, well, Heather, you don't understand because, you know, you don't have children. And I'm thinking, listen, you can argue for your limitations and make yourself right, or you can get out of your story and say, you know what, I am going to do what I need to do. And I have to tell you, I've worked with other women, single mothers, that are putting themselves out there and they're doing it. The more time you spend complaining and saying this is terrible, you get stuck. So my whole thing and my whole philosophy is moving past that needle of being in the stuck state. You know, forget about what happened yesterday. Forget about what happened years ago. So I thought that was a really interesting quote. Let's see, what was another quote that he said? And this is taking lower and slower to load. Anyways, it's not coming up on my screen. Oh, here's another good one. On perfection and making mistakes. The next time someone complains that you have made a mistake, tell him that may be a good thing. Because without imperfection, neither you nor I would exist. And I think that's another thing. I mean, how many times do you get stuck in your head and you don't take action because you're waiting for something to be perfect, or you beat yourself up because things didn't go exactly as you planned? And I'm here to tell you, all successful leaders, they learn how to fail forward, or they learn how to fail up. And you've got to be comfortable failing. I mean, many times I have failed miserably. And how I've picked myself back up is saying, okay, I know I'm here to do greater things. I know I have a mission and purpose, and I'm not going to let this one incident stopped me from taking action. And I'm telling you, it's so easy to put yourself in a box and say, well, I can't move forward because this happened. And I'm here to tell you is that if you get comfortable being uncomfortable with knowing that you're going to fail, things aren't going to work out, it's going to be easier for you to move the needle. Now, in my La Dolce Vita Thought Leader Academy, I teach the science of success. I teach women leaders how to be fearless and fabulous in their business and in their life. And it starts with the mind. Your success starts in your mind first. If you're not willing to master your mindset, don't expect to master your business. Don't expect to master the other areas of your life. You can't just go and market your business first and think everything's going to be perfect. You have to work on your vision and mission and purpose and why you're here on this planet. And you've got to align your mind to your vision. You've got to know who you are and set goals that are aligned with who you are, and then constantly refine that process and stretch who you are. Because you will not become a leader if you think small. And if you, you know, anytime you have a setback, you start beating yourself up. And I can tell you, I've done that many times. I beat myself up. I'm like, oh, why am I not over here? I should be further along. And it's interesting because as I evolved as a person and my business has evolved, I get my clients that go through the same thing. So if you're thinking this right now, do not beat yourself up. I really want you to know, if you're listening to this right now or watching this, that you're watching or listening for a reason. You're here to really absorb this message and realize that if you're stuck, don't give up. Find another way. You can do it, right? And one of the things that I know really helps if you're stuck, if you're so in your own way, is that you want to remove yourself from your physical space. So let's just say you're at home, you're working on your business, and something goes wrong, and it happens. I want you to go to your favorite spot. I know for me, it's going to Starbucks. I have a Starbucks I can literally walk to, and I definitely designed that in my vision. I actually did. I had a plan where I'm like, I want to live right near a coffee shop that it's at least in walking distance. And as I evolve myself and my business, guess what? Here we go. It's right in front of me, just literally right in front of me. But anyways, you go to your happy place. That might be a Starbucks. It might be something different. If you're like, Heather, I don't like Starbucks, that's fine. Just don't make me wrong. But anyways, you want to go to your happy place, or like I like to call it your Zen place, that place that you can align your thoughts, your ideas, your vision. You get it out on paper. I like to journal, and I like to write down things that are aligned with who I am. Actually, one of the things I designed is my 90-day La Dolce Vita planner. And it's so different than any planner that's out there. So it actually shows you the science of aligning your mind. So I think it's 7 steps that take you through the process of doing that. And then you create your day. You write down exactly what you need to do, prioritize it. And then there's a space to kind of journal and draw and plan things out. So I give you this whole 90-day version of planning. And I have found that if you chunk your goal down to 30, 60, 90-day goal, and you keep working on it every single day, you're going to get your goal. So if you want to pick up a copy of that, go to ladochevitaplanner.com. I believe it's ladochevitaplanner.com. If that's not the right URL, you can email me support@heatherpicken.com. We'll send you the link, and then you can get your planner. So again, I just want to encourage you that if you feel stuck, realize that every successful, fearless, and fabulous female entrepreneur goes through the same thing. You're no different. You know, the thing is, you haven't been given the tools and the strategies to get out of your own way and really to reprogram your mind for success. I believe you're here for a reason. I believe that you do have what it takes to create the success that you want. And you know, make a mark on this planet, whatever that is, whatever you want to do, be, and have. And, you know, you're just here to live what I call your La Dolce Vita life. And that is the sweet life. Whatever that looks like to you, you're here to fulfill it. Because, you know, I look at it this way. After all, what else do you have to do than fulfill your life's mission and purpose and really, you know, make a difference in the world? So if you found this episode to be helpful, please rate, review, and subscribe, like I said, on iTunes or YouTube. Write a review. Let people know how these episodes are helping you, because I am so inspired to share this with you. I could be talking about this 24/7, but obviously I've got work to do. I gotta go. So until next time, this is Heather Picken with La Dolce Vita, the formula for fabulous living. Take care. So if you found this show to be fabulous, share with your fabulous friends, rate, review, and subscribe on YouTube and iTunes. Wow. I'll make sure I take a beatbox lesson, right? Or give my little chihuahua a bone.